Good morning, students. I am Ms. Republika Borgohain, Assistant Professor, Assam Downtown University, Guwahati, Department of Pharmaceutical Science. So today we'll be discussing about what is the role of potassium in the body. So potassium plays a major role in maintaining fluid and electrolyte balance and cell integrity. It also critically maintains the nerve impulse transmissions and muscle contractions. Now, how to intake potassium? It is abundant in all living cells, both plant and animal, because cells remain intact unless foods are processed. The richest sources of potassium are fresh foods. To meet adequate intake for potassium, increase food and vegetable intake to 5 to 9 servings daily. So to get the adequate intake of potassium, we will have to increase the fruit and vegetable intake up to 5 to 9 servings daily. So now comes the role of calcium. So 99% of the body's calcium is in the bones and teeth, where it plays two roles. Firstly, it is an integral part of bone structure, providing a rigid frame that holds the body upright and serves as attachment points for muscles, making motion possible. Secondly, it serves as a calcium bank, offering a readily available source of the mineral to the body fluids. Should a drop in blood calcium occur? Secondly, it is saying that it serves as a calcium bank, offering readily available source of the mineral to the body fluid should a drop in blood calcium occur. Now, calcium and its disease prevention. Calcium may protect against hypertension. For example, with the dietary approaches to stop hypertension diet, which is not particularly low in sodium but is rich in calcium, and as well as magnesium and potassium. The dietary approaches to stop hypertension diet, together with a reduced sodium intake, is more effective in lowering blood pressure than either strategy alone. Now, the idea about calcium and obesity. The calcium may also play a role in maintaining a healthy body weight. In particular, calcium from dairy foods but not from supplements seems to influence body weight. An adequate dietary calcium intake may help prevent excessive fat accumulation by stimulating hormonal action that targets the breakdown of stored fat. Now, how to intake calcium? For adolescents up to the age of 18, 1300 mg of calcium per day should be taken. Between the ages of 19 to 50, 1000 mg of calcium per day should be taken. And in case of older adults over 50, a higher recommendation of calcium is given at 1200 mg per day to minimize bone loss that occurs later in life. So the presence of calcium in foods. Some cultures do not use milk in their cuisines. Some vegetarians exclude milk as well as meat, and some people are allergic to milk protein or lactose intolerant. Others simply do not enjoy the taste of milk. So some tofu, corn tortillas, some nuts such as almonds, and some seeds such as sesame seeds can supply calcium for the person who does not use milk products. Also, vegetables, mustard and turnip greens, bok choy, kale, parsley, water chest and broccoli are also good sources of calcium. Now comes the role of phosphorus in the body. Phosphorus also found in not only in bones and teeth but also in the body cells as a part of a major buffer system. It also acts as a part of DNA and RNA and is therefore necessary for all growth. Now, its recommendations and intakes. Phosphorus is found in almost all foods. Foods rich in proteins are the best sources of phosphorus. Research shows that displacement of milk in the diet by cola drinks, not the phosphoric acid content of the beverages, has adverse effects on bone. Now, the role of magnesium in the body. In addition to maintaining bone health, magnesium acts in all the cells of the soft tissues, where it forms part of the protein-making machinery and is necessary for energy metabolism. So how we should intake magnesium? So average dietary magnesium estimates for US adults fall below recommendations. It can be found in legumes, seeds and nuts, and also in leafy green vegetables. Now, lastly, discussing about sulfate and its role in the life processes. So sulfate is the oxidized form of the mineral sulfur as it exists in food and water. The body's needs for sulfate are easily met by a variety of foods and beverages. In addition, the body receives sulfate from the amino acids methionine and cysteine found in dietary proteins. Because sulfate needs are easily met with normal protein intake, so there is no recommended intake for sulfate. So this was the role of each and every chemical, that is sulfate, magnesium, that vitamins, how they work in our day-to-day life processes. So in my next video, I will be continuing with the role of vitamins in our body. Thank you.